Let's install Plumsail Forms for SharePoint Online. Click Start Trial and enter your name and email address. This email address will be used to create a new Plumsail account. Select Forms for SharePoint Online and click Submit. Now you need to think of a password and input it twice. Click Create Account. You'll see an instruction which you need to follow. First, download Form Web Part, which you need to upload to the app catalog. Go to your SharePoint, open Microsoft 365 Admin Center, click Show All, go to SharePoint, and you'll see SharePoint Admin Center. Click More Features. Now you need to find Apps and click Open. Here you'll see an App Catalog feature. Click on it. If you don't have an App Catalog, create one. Well, just input all the data, select an admin, and click OK. Once the app catalog is created, or if you already have one, you just need to open it. So, go to the URL, distribute apps for SharePoint, click Upload, find and upload the package you just downloaded, Plumsail Form SP package. Click OK, and very importantly, select Make the solution available to all sites in the organization. Alright, once it's deployed, make sure it is properly deployed and it's tenant deployed. It's very important. Alright, next step is to add your domain to the licenses page. Go to the licenses page, click Add Tenant, and just copy and paste your SharePoint URL. Click Add, and if you want to grant permissions, you'll need to use global admin for your SharePoint domain. This has to be a global admin and not a SharePoint admin. Click Accept. And you won't need to activate scripts manually. You can avoid this, but then you'll need to do it manually each time. All right, last step is to install the designer. Download the setup file and run it like any other installation application. After the app is installed, it will launch. You will need to go to SharePoint app and enter a web URL of your SharePoint site. Log in as someone with full control access to the site, so you can edit forms and save them. Open the list you want to modify forms for, and it will load all the data from the list. The columns will be available as fields, you'll be able to modify new and edit and display form, and you'll also be able to modify forms for different content types. Alright, just drop fields onto the form, customize them as necessary. For example, I will add a label and I'll make my fields wider. I'll click Save and I'll save all three forms at once. Then I'll go and modify forms for the task content type. Each content type has its own forms and I will modify this one similarly. Once it's modified, I will also save all three forms. And I will go to the modified list. If you already had it opened, just refresh it. Click New. And here you see the new form. I clicked a new item, but I want a new task instead. Alright, it changes automatically and I can populate the form and all its fields. Click Save, and as you can see, a new task has been saved, our installation is successful, and I hope you enjoy using the product.